So there's these set of photographs out now that show various different women trying to promote their acceptance movement. The body, it boils down to just obesity, love, and promotion. Like people saying it's okay to be fat, it's okay to stuff fucking fat pills down my cock holster, and you should accept me for that. You should be appreciative because I'm a strong, independent, fat woman. No. You're unhealthy, you're lazy, and you're making excuses why you are the way you are. Because the majority of these fucking window lickers out there are sitting there demanding that the entire world changes to appease them, because essentially the majority of them are fucking lazy. Again, let me preface it with this. There are those with medical excuses. Medical reasoning. But even those I see out there trying to fight back. And change time and how it works and change their bodies and continue to fight. But in the meantime, you've got these fat-ass feminists out there screaming at the top of their lungs, like, we should be accepted for who we are. Why? Why should I accept you for being fucking lazy and promoting that unhealthy lifestyle to other younger women? You influence these young girls into thinking it's okay to be morbidly obese. When we all know, well, maybe not all of us, but a good portion of Americans now know, the leading killer of Americans is heart disease. It's not even cancer. It's heart disease. We are an obese nation. But you continue to go down that road and lead more people to their death. But there's going to be gym douches like me that are going to stand up. And I don't give a fuck what society says about being a fat shamer. The truth is the truth. If you're fat and the pants don't fit, so be it. That's the truth. And if I'm the one that says it, tough shit. But no matter how many fat feminists you got out there rallying to your cause, yanking out their tampons and whipping them around their head like fucking war banners, you're not going to change the fact that there are people out there like me that will stand against you and call you out for what you are. Fucking lazy hypocrites that promote death, that promote laziness. You're not bettering yourself. You're not promoting some kind of noble cause. You know what body love and image issues should be accepting of? Burn victims. Women with breast cancer that had breasts removed. Stretch marks from women that gave birth. But the thing is, your types out there will try and twist this narrative to where it's coming across like John saying you've got to be a bodybuilder. John says you've got to be shredded. No, John says be healthy. John says take care of the only body you've got. But you always bring it back to this beauty comparison, just like fucking Tess Holliday and her bunch of fucking window-looking idiots out there. The same thing. Fuck your beauty standards. I got news for you. You're not beautiful. I'm sorry. In my opinion, you're not. My dick is not attracted to you. I must have a fat-shaming dick. That's what it's gotta be. I got a fat-shaming dick. I don't find it attractive that you put no effort, no discipline into taking care of yourself. None. I'm sorry, but a woman that lacks ambition and personal discipline probably bleeds over into other aspects of her life. But hey, she's beautiful the way she is. Not to me, she's not. Might have a good personality, like I said before, but your body is not. I don't find it attractive whatsoever. Some people do. Some people love this big, beautiful woman movement. That's fine. Your sexual fetish can help enable people to continue killing themselves. And now we promote this shit with these videos on Facebook saying, I want to be the most fattest woman out there, the fattest guy out there. Yeah, good cause. Great way to, you know, that's a noble effort right there. That's exactly how I want my children to be. I would love them following a piece of shit like you. Fuck that. So you ladies out there, you men out there that want to promote this body love image movement shit, no, it's not. You're doing it for the wrong reasons. You've always been doing it for the wrong reasons, but nobody wants to say anything, because if they do, they'll be labeled a fat shamer. Look, I was fat too, and guess what? If you're fat as a result of your poor eating habits, you should be ashamed. But it doesn't mean you can't change it. It doesn't mean that you can't take a step in the right direction and help yourself, help save your life, but we're all gonna die eventually. Yes, but what was your quality of life like until that point? Right now, I feel incredible. I went from 250 pounds down to like 195 pounds by changing my diet, by feeling incredible, and teaching my children the exact same thing. And it's a wonderful mindset. It's a wonderful feeling. Anyone can be that way if they're willing to get off their fucking ass and want it. Well, I don't go to the gym because I'm intimidated by people like you. Bullshit. That's a fucking excuse and you know it. If you want something bad enough, you'll go out there and you'll make it fucking happen. It's in your blood. It's all you can think about. It's everything. It's everything that surrounds you. But when you don't want it, you will find an excuse. But when it's in the very fiber of your being, nothing will stop you from pursuing and conquering that goal. That's what I encourage you young women out there to do. Don't follow these pieces of shit out there. They don't care about you. They won't pay your hospital bill, and they won't be there at your bedside when you're dying. Think about that. In the arena.